on broccoli?
It's snack time at the home of Ruth Fajardo in Norwalk, Connecticut, an hour outside New York City.
How was school?
Good. Hi.
Ruth, a 26-year-old immigrant from Honduras, checks in with her four young kids. A normal family scene. But 4 years ago, the family was in a very different place.
Everything was really a disaster.
Ruth was a stay-at-home mom, living alone with her kids in public housing. The children's father, a house painter who supported the family, had gone back to Honduras. One night, while the children were sleeping upstairs, bullets came flying through the windows and front door.
Everything was breaking in the kitchen, the glass and the mirrors and everything. Everything was like a horror movie.
It was a random drive-by shooting. Ruth's children weren't physically hurt, but her older daughters, Andrea and Michelle, can't shake the memory.
Yeah, I was scared. I was crying.
I thought I would die.
My mom, she was, because she could have gotten shot too. So I was scared that she was going to die.
And we were going to foster home.
That didn't happen. But Ruth, with no job, no driver's license, and no high school diploma, was scraping by on cash from having sold the two family cars. Ruth moved in with her mother. She and the four kids shared one room.
I was really sad because having them all together sleeping in one mattress was messed up. I felt it wasn't fair.
She felt like she couldn't help her kids, including the second oldest, who was being bullied at school, crying all the time, and hiding in the closet. Ruth fell into a deep depression.
Everything stressed me. I get angry easily. So my kids were like that. They were screaming at each other. They were fighting a lot. So I thought I was transmitting that to them.
You were transmitting that?
Yes.
That's interesting, Jack.
Jack Shonkoff is a pediatrician and director of the Harvard Center on the Developing Child. He says stressful situations provoke a physical response.
Automatically, our heart rate goes up, our blood pressure goes up, stress hormone levels rise in the blood, our blood sugar goes up. It's the biology of the fight or flight response.
Shonkoff says for children, stress is normal and fine in the short term, but chronic, long-term exposure to stress is something very different. He calls this toxic stress. Shonkoff's research shows toxic stress can have profound consequences for human bodies and brains, especially in young children.
Toxic stress is creating a different kind of chemical environment in the brain. Toxic stress can disrupt brain circuits that will basically create a weaker foundation for a lot of the circuitry that's essential for learning, for memory, for solving problems, for following rules, for controlling impulses.
Anyone can experience toxic stress, but Shonkoff says poverty presents the type of chronic adversity that can cause it. Low-income families are also more likely to live in neighborhoods with high rates of crime, drug abuse, and failing schools. Over the last few years, many other scientists have also found links between growing up poor and differences in cognitive development.
Will all kids who grow up in a high poverty situation experience toxic stress or the long-term effects of toxic stress?
One thing that's absolutely clear is that not all children growing up in poverty are experiencing toxic stress. Toxic stress has to do with the extent to which adults in a child's life are buffering that child from the stresses around the family and building the child's ability to cope and adapt, which is building resilience. And the most at-risk group are parents who themselves grew up in poverty, were victims of abuse and neglect.
When Ruth was a baby, her mother left for the U.S.
I was 18 months when she left me with my grandma in Honduras.
She was raised by her grandmother, who was illiterate. Then she experienced trauma as a young teen.
I was molested, but nobody in my family knew.
She never got help and struggled after coming to the U.S. 4 years ago, isolated and with few resources, she plunged into depression.
And we know the impact of depression on young children is devastating.
Darcy Lowell is a pediatrician and founder of Child First, a nonprofit group that works with low-income families in Connecticut and helped Ruth Fajardo. Lowell says Low-income moms like Ruth experience depression at rates much higher than the average. And depression can make it harder to provide the nurturing relationship so vital for children's development.
That relationship is the foundation of not just emotional development and mental health. It is the foundation for cognition, for school readiness, for a sense of competence, and that's what leads to children to be successful in their lives.
Ruth didn't realize the costs of not interacting with her kids.
When they try to make me read, I just tell them I don't like reading. I didn't pay attention to schoolwork or checking their backpacks. And my kids always are bugging me, let's go to the park, let's go outside. And I couldn't because I was feeling down.
Did it seem like your mom was happy or did it seem like your mom used to be sad?
Sad? A little. Her eyes are red and her face is red.
And sometimes water's in her eyes.
And how did that make you guys feel to see her like that?
Sad, so
I felt guilty because I made my mom feel sad.
Ruth says one day she saw her oldest daughter playing with the other kids, pretending to be Ruth.
And she starts screaming at them, stop fighting, you're gonna get everything ruined and you're bad kids and stuff like that. And when I saw her being so mean with the other one screaming, that's when I started looking for help.
Ruth found Child First, which provides home visits and counseling at no cost to 1,000 low-income families in Connecticut.
Hi, guys.
A pair of Child First counselors visited Ruth's family for about 2 years. A care coordinator found Ruth a Spanish-speaking therapist who helped diagnose Ruth and get her on medication. She also helped Ruth obtain a driver's license, clothes and food from local charities, and enrolled her kids in preschool and summer programs.
How is she doing, developmentally? She's okay?
Yes, they just did this test at school, she passed.
What happened, your mom?
At the same time, Ruth learned better parenting skills.
You want to have your own time right now?
The importance of listening to her kids instead of punishing them, talking about their feelings, and modeling good behavior.
Me too.
The kids did activities to help them learn how to cooperate more and fight less, and how to better manage their emotions.
This is how he handles now his anger. Before, he should scream and mess up everything, like fighting and...
A 2011 study compared 78 children in the Child First program to children not in the program. It showed a 68% drop in language problems and a 42% drop in aggressive behavior. For moms, there was a 64% decrease in depression and other mental health problems. But with about 250,000 children living in low-income families in Connecticut alone, the group struggles to meet the demand for its services, which it estimates cost about $7,800 for a family of four.
When I think about 300 children on the wait list here in Connecticut and their families, it's very hard. We're going for the source of the problem. We're going for the root of the problem.
You okay? You're done?
Today, Ruth and her family are in a much better place.
My depression is practically gone. I feel so better. Now I'm more empowered, energetic.
2 weeks ago, Ruth graduated high school and was selected to give a speech about overcoming obstacles. Her story featured on the local evening news. She now works two part-time jobs, and the children's father has joined them.
I have an A++.
Oh, wow. That means you did way awesome.
Her next goals, college, and then she wants to buy a house. But for now, this family of six is living on about $30,000 a year, still near the federal poverty line, and they still rely on food stamps and Medicaid. But Ruth says she's more equipped now to handle whatever comes their way.
I can say I'm happy, and I can tell I'm transmitting happiness to my kids.